We are in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning. Discover Newport has brought us one of our close friends. Chef Matthew MacCartney is making cod acqua pazza. Crazy water.
Crazy water.
Crazy
exactly.
Water. That's what's going on. It's great to have you here today.
Thank you.
All right. So tell us what this dish is first, because you hear the crazy water. Not really
right.
Sure what that is.
So I believe the story goes that the Neapolitan fishermen created the dish. They used to just take a little seawater, throw it in a pan, and just quickly poach it, and add a little hot pepper, a little garlic, so it's a little spicy and
sure.
You know, a little angry water, you know, and then I think it was the Tuscans who really termed the phrase. Acqua pazza.
Got it. Okay. All right. So, looks like an easy recipe. You
it
don't
is.
Have too many things.
Not too
to,
many things.
To put this together, but let's go over the ingredients that we need.
The basis of the dish is white wine, garlic. We have beautiful little heirloom cherry tomatoes, parsley, little hot pepper.
Mm-hmm.
Then, in order to make it a little more substantial, added potatoes, a little broccoli rabe, which everybody loves.
Nice.
And a secret ingredient, a little touch of anchovy, just to give it a, which I know you love, just to give it a little extra depth.
All right, let's talk about the fish itself that you're going to be using to make this.
Yep, we're using local cod.
Mm-hmm.
You can use basically any white fish. Any flaky white fish will work perfectly. Monkfish, scup is another
right.
Good local fish. Halibut would work well.
And obviously, like you said, this is local stuff, easy enough to get at any location.
Exactly.
What do we need to look for? Is there something you need to look at?
If all the ingredients are good, you can't go wrong.
You can't go wrong.
And don't overcook it. 5-6 minutes, you'll see later.
Easy enough. Usually he's bringing us wine. We've got
a little wine
there.
He's got
a little wine. That's one of his. That's one of his things. Things down at the restaurant are going great. We're going to put this together. Easy enough to do. Not many ingredients that you actually have to use for this. We'll put this together. Show you how we do it. We'll talk about the everything that's going on down at the restaurant. All the great things, because he said it's very, very busy. So in the meantime, back to you.
Yeah, that's right. I await with Chef Matthew from Jamestown Fish. Thanks to Discover Newport for bringing you back in.
Thank you.
You got a great fresh dish. You were talking about the simplicity of this one.
Simplicity of it. The cod acqua pazza could be done with any flaky white fish.
Mm-hmm.
Again, as I said to Will, it was just a fisherman's dish. They used to take seawater and just use that as the poaching liquid. So now we've upgraded to white wine.
You've cleaned it up a bit.
white wine. You got beautiful sun gold tomatoes, heirloom sun gold tomatoes,
mm-hmm.
parsley. I added potato. And broccoli rabe to make it a little bit of a more substantial dish for the restaurant.
Sure.
But that's the basis of it. The fish just poaches and makes its own little broth.
I love that. I love when this counter is basically clear, because it's not intimidating either for folks at home.
Mm-hmm.
About how long does it take to make a dish like this?
Well, you have to pre-cook the potatoes, which don't take a ton of time.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, cut you can do all your, as we say, mise en place and chop your parsley, have your tomatoes cut. The broccoli rabe pre-blanched, but
mm-hmm.
if that's all ready, we're 5 minutes from putting this on the table and it's perfectly cooked.
Great, and we've got our fish ready to go too, right?
So I've seasoned the fish on both sides,
mm-hmm.
poured a little olive oil so it doesn't stick in the end, and then you would add a little bit of white wine, which is gonna, now it looks like a lot, so
yep.
it's a little more than a half a cup, but that's gonna poach and it's gonna reduce and make a nice little sauce.
Beautiful. When you are poaching this, what is the temperature
parsley,
that we're looking for? Is
a it very low heat.
Very low.
You don't want to
okay.
treat the fish in a rough manner. Just sort of just poach, just delicate, not like a saute.
Got it.
And then the tomatoes are in. Now the tomatoes are going to give their juice into this broth.
Mm-hmm.
The fish is going to give itself into the broth. A little bit of garlic that's chopped.
So you're preparing this before
right.
you're even putting the heat on.
Mm-hmm. Before you even put the heat on. And then
okay.
and you can even do this, you know, beforehand.
Mm-hmm.
There's a few beautiful fingerling tomatoes.
Great.
Hot pepper, which is sort of the crazy part.
The kids can even help add this
you
in because there's no
right.
heat yet.
There's
okay.
no heat. And then the magic ingredient, which is optional, is just a couple of pieces of anchovy.
Beautiful.
That give
Look
it
at
a
that.
Little bit of depth.
We are
and
ready
just
to go.
Melt right in.
And we're going to turn the heat on soon and finish this dish when we come back.
Jamestown Fish is the place. We got cod acqua pazza, crazy water on the menu thanks to Discover Newport. You are cooking away.
Yeah, we're
yeah.
cooking away.
Yep.
So when we left earlier,
mm-hmm.
I put on the flame very, very low, and this is just about 5 minutes,
okay.
and there you go, and you can smell it. Unfortunately,
Yum.
Not on the camera. So here is the, we're pretty much ready to plate. If you look at the cod, you see that it's just starting to naturally flake like that, and that's exactly what you want. You don't want to cook it too much. You want to keep it nice and moist, which this is
flip?
A moist cooking. No, you wouldn't
just
even be
it.
Able to. If you tried to flip
it'll
it.
It'll fall apart.
It'll all fall apart. That's,
right.
you know, the beauty of the flaky white
know.
Fish. I warmed up the broccoli rabe separate. That doesn't mean you couldn't cook it in there, but
mm-hmm.
you don't want it to overcook.
Does the taste differ at all between broccoli and broccoli rabe?
This is a little, I would say regular broccoli is a little bit more sweet, where this has a little bit more bitterness, and you only have those little small florets, as they call them, whereas, and more leaves, all right? So then the next part is just to very gingerly take the fish out.
Scoop
lots of color, right? You can see it right there already.
That's
trying.
A good
it wants
sign
to
when it,
it wants to flake
like
that, and you can see it's a little opaque still, which is fantastic. And then you can just spoon over.
You can see
the
even just that broth. What's happened in that time that we last left you, of how the rest of those vegetables have seeped into the white wine.
So imagine you have the white wine, the hot pepper, the garlic, and a potato acts like, you know, the potato, the fish, everything acts like almost like a sponge to just suck
take
up
in
all that beautiful flavor. And it's sort of the epitome of simple Italian cooking, where you get this one flavor out of all these great ingredients, and always a little raw extra virgin olive oil to
finish it off. Looks a little lighter than a typical Italian dish as well.
It's it's so beautiful for the summer, and you can use all the nice heirloom tomatoes that are ripe now. But you could do this all year round. You could just use canned tomatoes in the winter.
And you said any flaky white fish.
Any flaky white fish would work. You wouldn't want to do this with tuna and things. I think would just overpower.
Mm-hmm. Right.
All right.
And you're the guy who knows fish very well. Jamestown Fish is the place. How has it been since the Labor Day rush? I feel like a lot of places in that area, they get really crazy and hectic.
It starts
during summer.
And then it really peaks around 4th of July.
Mm-hmm.
August is fantastic. Now Labor Day happens. But now a lot of the folks come back to Rhode Island and they're visiting again, and it all works out very symbiotically.
And Lexi, who works on our show, her and her mom went down to see you.
Great.
She said this morning, she said it was one of the best meals her and her mother have ever had. So
that was fantastic.
That says a lot.
Good.
That says a lot.
Now, in terms of variety, what else is on your menu? Clearly fish.
Yeah, clearly we have, oh my gosh, six different kinds of fish every night.
Yeah.
We do octopus as an appetizer. It has gone crazy. We have all the little snacks, the little smelts and things like that. Tuna, swordfish. We tried shark this year. That was fantastic. People love that. We always do something exotic like Dover sole or Dorade from Europe just to show off something a little different.
And you said there's something for me too.
That will be something for you. Beautiful. We do very well with meat too.
Yeah.
So a nice veal porterhouse.
Nice.
Right up your alley.
Good stuff.
And you, I mean, the food is great, and you are great too, because you've had many accolades, and very recently too.
It's been a very good
year. Just brought you on our show. Remind folks at home of what your
earlier in the year, I won the People's Best New Chef, which was fantastic, from Food & Wine magazine. Mm-hmm. And then a few months after that, we got a very nice award, which we talked about one time on the show, for wine.
Sure.
Where we are one out of six restaurants in the state that got the two glass award from the Wine Spectator, so...
That's
a lot
great
going on.
For you as a chef. You know, you got a lot going on down there, and the restaurant's been very successful.
Very
and a lot of people in and out loving the food that you make.
It smells delicious.
Good.
So make sure you grab this and a glass of wine.
Sure.
It's top notch over at Jamestown Fish. You can find this recipe at WPRI.com.